The chapter is electric charge and electric field. The first topic in this chapter is Coulomb's law. Coulomb's law gives the magnitude and direction of the electric force acting between the two charged particles for a given distance for a given medium. So let's see what is Coulomb's law. Coulomb's law gives magnitude and direction of electric force acting between two charged particles for a given distance for a given medium. So let's see, suppose there are two charged particles, Q1 and Q2, right? And the separation between them is supposed R. So the force, electric force acting between these two charged point like charged particle for a given distance is directly proportional to the product of their charges and inversely proportional to the square of the distance between them according to Coulomb's law for electrostatic force. If we combine these two equations, then we get Q1 Q2 upon R square. If we remove proportionality, then we put up a constant, and the constant is K. K Q1 Q2 upon R square, where value of K is 9 into 10 raised to 9 MKS, and K is also equal to 1 upon 4 by epsilon 0. Further, where epsilon 0 is permittivity of vacuum. And its length is 8.85 into 10 to the minus 12 MKS. Epsilon 0 gives the permittivity of the vacuum. For the medium which is other than the vacuum, the equation of the force between two charged particles is given by Fm is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 upon R square, where epsilon is the absolute permittivity of given medium. If we take the ratio of this equation, then we get Fm upon F is equal to 1 upon 4 pi epsilon Q1 Q2 upon R square divided by 1 upon 4 pi epsilon 0 Q1 Q2 upon R square. So these two terms cancel out. We get Fm upon F is equal to epsilon 0 upon epsilon. The reciprocal of this equation is F upon Fm is equal to E upon epsilon 0. E upon epsilon 0 is the relative permittivity of a given medium, and it is denoted by the symbol epsilon r as well as capital K. Relative permittivity is also known as the dielectric constant. And K is dielectric constant. Right? The value of absolute permittivity is always greater than the value of permittivity of vacuum. That's why the K is always greater than 1. Because if epsilon is greater than epsilon 0, then epsilon upon epsilon 0 is greater than 1, which is K. K is equal to epsilon r is greater than 1. So the relative permittivity of any medium is always greater than 1. So we get the least amount of or least magnitude of the force in a vacuum